Yo, what's up guys, Boss here, and I'm back on the YouTube video, and I'm really excited about this one because we finally got the exclusive emote from finishing top 100 in the last global tournament. I finished 40th, and that was enough to get me this emote right here, and it's so rare. To give you guys a perspective of how rare it is, there's like 2,000 people who have the 20 win badge. There's only 200 people who have this emote because there's been two global tournaments so far since they've added this emote in the top 100 of each. That's 200 people that have this emote. So I thought a fun way to test this out would be BMing people and making a video on it so you guys can like see it in action. And we can also see like what people's reactions are like when they see the emote. So here's the like emote in action right here if you guys haven't already seen it or heard it. That's what it sounds like. It looks like it's pretty cool in my opinion. I have sound on in this video purposely so you guys would be able to hear it. So what we're going to do is we're just going to play some ladder games. I'm at like 5,075 right now as a level 11, so not bad. And we're basically just going to be BMing people on ladder whenever we do a good play or just at the beginning of the game like this, just for no reason, honestly, to see if we can get like a reaction out of people. He's even going with the crying face here. I think he might even know like that, like the emote. So I think we already got a reaction out of it. So yeah, we stopped the hog there. That means we're going to use the emote again. And we're just going to use it throughout the game whenever we make a good play. Or when we win, of course, we're going to be spamming it. And that's just what we're going to be doing, basically. So we get a connection there with the Goblin Brawler. He does have a witch, so we're going to poison that. And then we're going to use the emote again because that was a good poison. He does go for a Valk, though. That was a pretty good Valk on his end. We can go with our Iwas here, and he is going to Fireball. So his Fireball does completely kill the Iwas. We're going to let that Witch go, and then we're going to use the emote again, because we're actually up in Elixir right now, and we're actually up in damage. So pretty much good reason to use it, and he's not going to do anything. As I said, we were up in Elixir. Let's just go ahead and drop a Night Witch. He's going to go for Furnace. That was good because that should be able to take care of the Goblin Cage and the Brawler. I think we'll snowball that. Let's see if he plays something else that we want to poison. But it looks like as of right now, he's playing pretty well. That was a good Prince. And Bats, that's not enough value for me to poison them. So I think what we want to do here is just get an Ewiz on top of this Valk and Bats. That's our best play in that situation. Ooh, he's going to go for a Fireball, completely missing the Ewiz. So that was not good on his end. Now we have an opportunity, I feel like, to build up a push. He's probably going to use his Witch here, if I had to guess. We'll see, though. I have a feeling that's what he would do in this situation, though. Yes, there's the Witch. So I'm going to go ahead and actually go for a Graveyard. And then I'm going to go for a poison. And yes, guys, look at that. It's time to spam the emote because we are probably taking that tower. Yeah, so we're spamming the emote like crazy here. Just because we took his tower and I don't think he can really come back from this now. I mean, he is going to go for a Hog Rider, but we should be able to get to a snowball here, push this back, and save our tower. So here we go. We're going to be using the emote again. 20 seconds left. I don't really think there's really any way he can come back from this just because there's no time. And we will be able to defend it anyways. We have the Goblin Cage. So, like, if he drops a hog, we should be completely fine. Mega Knight's still up there. And then we go for Goblin Cage. So that's going to be a good game. Besides the crying face at the beginning, he's been pretty quiet most of the game. I'm not sure if he's going to do anything again here. Yeah, it looks like he doesn't. He's just stayed quiet basically the whole game ever since we started out using the emote. But yeah, we'll see if we get some like more reactions. Like maybe someone will say wow or something. Or I don't really know. But here, let's start off with the emote again here. See if this guy does anything. He's just gonna cycle a princess in the back. Alright, he's doing the Ice Wizard one. I don't really know what that means, but interesting. Lava Hound Princess. So already something a little bit off meta here. Dark Goblin. Yeah, very interesting lava deck for sure. So I think we're gonna need to get an Ewiz off on this here, and then possibly Snowball, depending on what he plays. Ewiz should be able to finish that off. Oh wow, Max Goblin gang, geez. Alright, we're going to be using it here, though. We have really nice defense. And Night Witch is going to get a little bit of damage there. So yeah, good opportunity to use it again. And then we can, oh wow, Balloon. So Lava Loon, his cards are definitely much higher level than ours, even though he's a level 11. So this will be interesting to see if we can win this. Let's, I guess we'll Goblin Cage here, because we definitely need to be able to pull that Balloon and distract it. But I'm worried it will get a hit, just because it is level 12. So it does get a hit. That's unfortunate. But I still think we can definitely come back, because I feel like our deck is better in double. It's pretty expensive. I mean, Mega Knight Graveyard is typically like how I get most of my damage in, like when I have the Mega Knight tanking for the graveyard. But you can also do like Night Witch tanking for it. So we're going to Mega Knight here. We are up quite a bit of Elixir. Let's go for a graveyard once this crosses over. And then we're going to also have to try to defend that Balloon. Ooh, this is good. Really good, actually, because that Lumberjack isn't going to be raging the Balloon at all. But the Balloon might end up getting a connection here. Ooh, no, it doesn't! That means we're using the mode again. Let's go. So our tower's still up at 880. We might even be able to defend the rest of the game. I mean, this might be kind of a long shot, because, I mean, he does have Lava Loon, and if he builds up, like, a push, he could easily take it, but... I mean, I guess we'll have to see what happens here. Night Witch is really solid at, like, stopping Lava Loon pushes, so we'll get that down. And since he's just going in for a Lone Loon, that's not really going to do anything. We can even Goblin Cage, pull this back, using the emote a ton here, because there's no way he can get through at this point. He doesn't have a Balloon in cycle. Lava Hound cannot make it in time. So that's going to be it. This guy has been quiet the whole time, too, kind of like the last guy. Just hasn't used anything, so let's just 3-crown him here. I'm not worried about the Lumberjack thing. We have this 3-crown really easily. Alright, there we go. Goes in for the wizard, He knew there was nothing he could do there at the end. Alright, we'll go for the next one here. Alright, level 12. We'll see if he has, like, high-level cards for level 12. Some have, like, low-level for level 12, but you never really know. So he goes in for the chicken, the chicken emote, and he used a lot of his elixir there. He went for Haw Goblins, but he should be able to stop this here with the Executioner. Well, actually, no, because Mega Knight jumps, so we could just snowball that, and it should go down here. Yeah, even after that Ice Spirit. So that means another opportunity to use our emote here. Look at all the damage we got on his tower. I mean, we don't have a huge lead, but that's obviously just because he's a level 12, so his tower has more HP than ours. But nice start. I mean, Valk. Okay, so we could Night Witch. We're not going to want to play stuff behind our king, because I feel like he has a rocket. So we need to play stuff like higher up. But that Executioner is going to get a lot of value versus like Night Witch and other things like that. So we do need to be careful. I'm going to get a Goblin Cage here because I had a feeling he was going to hog. And we can go ahead and just drop a Mega Knight, hitting both the Executioner and the Hog Rider, getting a lot of value out of them. So we can use the emote again. That was pretty good defense on our end. And now he's going to have to defend this, which is going to be hard for him, especially if we back it up with a Night Witch. Yeah, guys, I think he might lose tower here. Yeah, the Mega Knight ended up jumping on the tower. That was actually crazy. So this is just, we're spamming here. We are just... we took out his tower. We're just spamming him. We're really rubbing it in here. I kind of feel bad, but you know, like I said, we're testing out the emote. I'm sorry that these guys had to be the test monkeys. I mean, I had to test it out somewhere, but he's laughing, guys. He's not happy. Yeah, we can just giant snowball, go for a Goblin Cage here. You know, guys, I'm not used to BMing, but honestly, it makes the matches more fun. I see why now people BM. That doesn't mean I'm gonna BM. This will still probably be one of the only videos where I'm constantly BMing. But I mean, I don't know. I don't usually BM, but I see why people do it now. It's pretty fun, especially when you have an emote that's new. So yeah, there's. I don't think you can break through here. We just had such a huge lead at the beginning. It's too hard for him to come back. With only 30 seconds to go as well. To be fair, we do have a lot of answers to Fog, which helps too, with the Mega Knight and the Goblin Cage, but you know, we're still gonna rub it in here, spam the emote a bit more. Oh, I clicked the wrong one. Gosh dang it, that was not the right emote. Oh well, I guess it's fine. Alright, well, I think he just completely gave up here. He's just not saying anything. I mean, I'm hoping to get more reactions, like some wows and stuff, because I don't know if people actually know this emote or, like, or are familiar with, like, the rarity of it, if that makes sense. Because I feel like we would have gotten more reactions if people knew that. So nice. We are going to pick up a tower skin. I am going to select that for sure. And then let's claim this here. Strike anything I don't think is that good. You know, a lot of these cards are really decent. Although I would say we could definitely get a better epic than the Hunter. And Sunday, probably. Yeah, I'll go with Pekka. Oh, yeah, we'll go with that. I could have also striked Rocket, but I guess it's okay. So let's go for the next game here. We're on a nice win streak here. 3 games in a row, right? Yeah, 3 games in a row. Another level 11. Will we get a reaction out of this guy? Here we go. We'll start off with the emote. See if he does anything. Again, he's not giving any reaction. Not even... Well, there's the Hawk Scream. Like, again, a lot of these guys at the beginning, they just use one single emote, and then they don't say anything else. I don't know if that's going to be the case for this guy, but we'll have to see. So, he has the Rage. Oh my goodness. Rage, guys, is not really that good, I'm going to be honest. It's just kind of like the E-barbs. Not really good. Well, Rage, even when overleveled, isn't that good. E-barbs are okay when they're really, really overleveled. The Rage, I just don't think is good in general. So, we're going to snowball that back. And that was a good play, so we'll use the emote. And we'll go ahead and Goblin Cage here. Just set up a defense. See what he wants to do. Ah, he's going to have Sparky. Okay, that's a little unfortunate because, I mean, we do have Uis to reset, but I didn't have, like, a Baby Dragon in cycle to just be able to cycle something same lane as it, which is a little unfortunate. But, I mean, I think going all out other lane here is the right play, just because he can't support a Sparky this way, and that means, you know, it should go down to all those bats spawning. Yeah, I think we're fine there. That worked out nicely. That level 12 Valk is going to be a little bit of an issue, though, defending, because Baby Dragon, I'm pretty sure the Valk's still going to get a couple swings on my tower, so that's a little unfortunate. Oh, it only got one hit. I think I kind of, overestimated the Valk there. I'm gonna poison here. I feel like there's no reason to not poison it, just because Wizard goes down. If I didn't poison it, I would have had to, like, cycle something into the Wizard that the Wizard would have gotten value on, and he hasn't, I don't think, shown anything this game that I need a poison besides the Wizard, so I feel like there's no reason to not poison it. Ah, another Sparky. Once again, I think we're gonna Mega Knight this lane, actually, just because it's double. I feel like we should be totally fine defending Sparky. We'll see, though. I need to definitely... There we go. That was a good use. And Sparky, does it go down here? Yes, it does. Oh my gosh, he's just spamming everything at the bridge. This guy's actually kind of a mad lad here. He's spamming everything at the bridge. It's kind of crazy. Alright, it's time to go for a first graveyard here. Might have been a little bit unsuccessful. No, we're getting damage. We're getting damage. You know, this might end up being kind of a long game here. Alright, we're gonna need a poison. We can't hit the tower, though, because we also need to get value on that Valk. I'm gonna definitely snowball this, because the Wizard wouldn't have died in the poison, because it's level 12, not level 11. Oh my goodness. And the Valk is splashing the tower. Ay-yi-yi, that's not good. Okay, so we need a Baby Dragon. There's no doubt about that. And then Mega Knight, and then Ewiz if needed, which we definitely might need here. Okay, the Baby Dragon stayed alive. That is really clutch, actually. All that should go down to the poison. You know what? It's triple elixir. We're going in here. Oh, that was perfect timing, right when he played Sparky in the back. Can we get damage here? We're going to Uis to help kill his Uis quicker. And then we're going to Snowball because we want to, like, slow down the Sparky, push away the Val. Now, this definitely could be troubling to defend. Nah, Goblin Cage is just great on defense, guys. It's Goblin Cage is really hard, in my opinion. We're gonna snowball that back. Oh my goodness, can we pull the defense off? He's just spamming everything at the bridge. It's actually kind of crazy. I feel like we need a poison here too, be really aggressive, just because we need to make sure we have more damage than him. And he played a wizard right into the poison. Alright, well, we have this win wrapped up here. We're gonna start spamming it again. Yep. Another nice win here against the guy who just spammed at the bridge. You know, none of these guys, I feel like, know what the emote's from. Because none have given, like, reactions, you know? So, well, okay, this guy at least used an emote at the end. He was one. I don't really know what emotion that really expresses. It kind of just, I don't know. It's kind of like one of those emotes where you don't really know, like, it doesn't really show how your opponent feels, if that makes sense. But anyways, we're on a really nice win streak here. 1, 2, 3, 4, four games. Let's go for one more. Try to get one last win for 5,200. See if we can get a reaction. If not, I guess we're just going to have to end off of, you know, maybe people just not knowing what it is. But it doesn't surprise me because, that could mean something. The wizard, I don't know, emote. I mean, I don't know. That could mean, he could. I don't know, though, because it doesn't, yeah, I don't know. That's questionable. Those archers, will be able to take care of everything. Ooh, he even goes for a Mega Knight. We're gonna need a defensive graveyard, just to stall this Mega Knight. And you know what? I don't know why he's laughing. He just played a Goblin Gang right into the Mega Knight. So actually, we're gonna be the ones emoting here. Well, okay. That Ram Rider, I don't think is gonna be too troublesome to defend. We'll see, though. I mean, it is level 12, but... Ah, yeah. We need to snowball it. What? The brawler didn't hit it. Oh my goodness. And his prince is level 13. No. Okay, hope. Oh my gosh. He's actually. I don't know if he's playing this well or that his cards are high level. I can't really tell. But man, we gotta make a comeback here. And then if we do, we know we're spamming the emote hard. And you know what? Even if we win, we're gonna spam it because. He's flexing all his emotes here. He doesn't have this one, though, so... They don't mean anything to me. Yeah, you know what? You don't have this one, so that doesn't... They, you know, real emotes there don't really mean anything to me. So, you know, that's fine. I mean, you might be winning, but you don't have this, so... I wish I had this on my main account, but the only difference would be is that a lot of people in the top 200 have emote, so it wouldn't really be, like, that exciting. Oh my goodness, how can we defend this? I don't think we can. No! Oh my god. Yeah, I think we're gonna lose here. This was unfortunate. He pretty much had all level, No! Alright, we're still spamming it. You don't have this. So, you can use all your emotes. You know, the crying ones, the laughing ones. You can even do BM Zap, but you don't have this, so... You can't make me feel upset. I have this. This is all I need. Right here. This is all I need. Yeah. So... I guess we'll play one more of them. But you can see, with this emote, I don't know, I feel like, since the other people don't have this emote, I don't feel as bad when they emote spam me with other stuff, because it just... Oh my gosh, he has max cards too. Jeez, okay. So, oh my goodness, and he's like spamming them all at the bridge. What? Okay, I feel like this is normal at this Drifter range. He's like, he's spamming everything at the bridge, and they're all maxed out. So, this is gonna be interesting. You get that leap, though, so... Okay, oh my goodness. Can we just get, like, a nice E-Wiz on top of everything here? And that'll also keep the Night Witch alive? Nice. Good defense. He took a while there to play the Mega Knight. We should be able to Goblin Cage here. I feel like with both towers hitting the Mega Knight, that's gonna basically, I feel like, take care of it. Yeah, Goblin Cage came in clutch there. That was a 4-for-7 trade. Not bad. Okay, we go Baby Dragon here. And then we might even Mega Knight. We gotta watch out for his Inferno Dragon, though, because we don't want that to, like, shred through our Mega Knight. Yeah, that which he played right there. So we need to make sure we, like, snowball to reset it, and then go for an E-Wiz on it. Just because... Oh my goodness. This should... You know what? We're fine. E-Wiz is gonna take care of the Inferno Drag, and it's even gonna distract the, Baby Dragon there. Ooh, this Fireball, though. Alright, we're gonna take this nice and slow. There's no reason to go aggressive here, going for, like, a graveyard yet. We need to be passive, wait until we have a chance. I'm not even gonna... I was thinking going Mega Knight at the bridge there, but, too aggressive. Interesting poison, but I think I'm gonna take it. I mean, if I played it one... Baby Dragon walked into it, so it's fine. It's good value. I mean, he was hitting the Valk, it's hitting the tower. You know, I don't even know what else we would put in this matchup anyways. He hasn't really shown, like, anything I would want to put in. So why not poison, you know, from a dragon? I don't see the reason why I wouldn't want to. Ah. Mega Knight got the leap off. That's kind of unfortunate. But, you know, this game's going okay. We're kind of taking it nice and slow, and I feel like eventually we're going to get somewhere. Oh my gosh, did he just miss the fireball? Okay, we have to go in now. Ooh, the Goblin Cage, or Brawler, I mean, almost got that second hit. That was so close. Good thing I waited to snowball. Oh my gosh, the Valk and the Skeleton Army. Oh gosh. Yeah, I think it would have been too aggressive. Okay, we need to do that just to cycle, and then we need to go first up. Oh my goodness. Please, let the Baby Dragon cross over. Don't block it. Okay, poison. Can he defend it? I don't think he can! Snowball does enough anyways. Yes, let's go! Oh my goodness, okay. Well, I guess that's gonna be it for the video. We played quite a lot of games there. We lost one, but, you know, we hit 5,200. And the thing is even when you lose, like, even when you lose, it doesn't even feel like a loss when you have this emote, honestly. Because you know that the other person doesn't have the emote. So, is it even really a loss, you know? I don't know. Anyways, this was a fun video. make sure to like the video if you enjoyed it. Subscribe if you're not subscribed already. And let me know in the comments, if you enjoyed this kind of video, maybe I'll do it again, later in the season on my, mini account. I've never done a video like this before. You guys know I never BM people usually in my videos, like, ever, but, you know, a lot of you guys wanted to see this. I thought it was pretty fun. I had a lot of fun. You know, I don't know if you guys are sick of hearing the emote now after the video, but, I think it was a great way to test out the emote. So, thanks again. Until next time, guys.